Hello, welcome to this video on direct assignment rules. In this video, you will familiarize with the most critical criteria that factors into creating an assignment rule for automatic ticket assignment. So let's quickly start off with understanding a few terminologies before we learn to create an assignment rule. As we all know, assignment rules help you automatically assign tickets that are received in your Zoho desk. It assigns incoming tickets to specific people or teams in your company based on a set of criteria. So what is a criteria? The rule based on certain specified conditions that route tickets to the appropriate department and further assign ownership to it. Next, let's see what are the benefits of assignment rules. Assignment rules ensure that every time someone creates a new ticket or moves a ticket to new status, it is automatically assigned to one of your agents. You need not sift through the ticket backlog and manually assign tickets. While this makes sense for new tickets, you can also trigger an assignment rule when tickets are updated in your help desk. A ticket assignment rule follows a workflow which is as follows. You first create a direct assignment rule and add targets to the rule. Then you define the rule criteria and finally save the rule. Though desk provides a number of criteria to choose from, the ones that you see on screen are the most critical criteria that play a vital role while creating a target. They are by channel, by customer type, by status, by priority, by sentiment, by keywords, overdue tickets, escalated tickets, response overdue tickets, and ticket on hold time. Let's take a look at each one of them, starting with the channel. To create an assignment rule, go to Setup and choose Assignment Rules under Automation. Click New Direct Assignment. Enter a rule name and description. You can execute this rule on new tickets or for ticket updates. Once you're done, click Add Target. In the Add Target page, select the department where the tickets would arrive and from the criteria section, choose channel and let us specify it as Twitter for now. And then select the department where you want the tickets to move to. Then assign a ticket to an agent or a team. Once you're done, click Save. Next is the rule based on customer type. This rule will help you assign tickets for premium customers to a dedicated team or agent. This will ensure that you do not miss out on tickets from most critical customers. So let's go ahead, click back. Again, let's create a new direct assignment and this is for customer type. Next, let's see an example for a rule based on status. This rule includes tickets with ticket status as backlog, awaiting customer response, servicing, awaiting tickets, and so on. So let's create a rule based on status. Click New Direct Assignment and enter a rule name and description. Click Add Target and select a department. Select status as the criteria and let us keep it as on hold. It is not always necessary that you have to assign tickets to a particular team or agent. You can also keep this option as unassigned, which means anybody can take up these tickets. Once you're done, click Save and the rule that you just created appears here. So next is a rule based on priority. Here you can assign tickets which are of high priority to the appropriate team or agent. So let's quickly see how to create one. Now here let us select the criteria as priority and we'll keep it as high priority and we'll assign these tickets to a team called speed agents. That's it. So next let us see a criteria called sentiment. This is what a target page looks like for a rule based on sentiment. The sentiment can be positive, negative, or neutral. Based on the sentiment of your ticket, you can channelize your tickets to the appropriate department or team. So let's quickly go and create a rule based on sentiment. So here we are creating a rule to assign tickets from unhappy customers to, just in case, a specific agent. So as we all know, let us select a department and let us select criteria as sentiment. And let us assign it to just in case in this example. And click save. Next, we will look at a rule based on keywords. You can include the keywords that you would like to track in tickets and assign them to the appropriate department. So, let's quickly start off. So, we are selecting the criteria as keywords. And you can specify the keywords. And we are moving the tickets to the Zphone departments and assign it to dedicated support team. Click save. So next is a rule based on overdue criteria. That is, if a ticket is overdue, if the ticket is not closed within a specified time period, you can route the tickets to the required team or agent for immediate action. So let's see how to create one. So the criteria that we select is overdue. So we are moving the tickets to the support team. Once you're done, click save. So next is the rule based on escalated criteria. This is similar to the overdue tickets. The only difference is that if the ticket is overdue, it is then escalated to the next level. And here you specify where the escalated tickets should be routed to. So here we are selecting the criteria as escalated and it is true. So this rule is based on response overdue criteria. That is, if a ticket response is overdue, you can route the tickets to the required team or agent. So let's go and create one. Let us select the criteria as response overdue, which is true. We'll move it to the support team. And save. Next is the rule based on ticket on hold time criteria. That is, you can assign rules to tickets based on their hold time, which can be the current time
or you can set a custom time. So let's go and create a rule for this criteria. Click New Direct Assignment. Enter a role name and description. Click Add Target. Select a department. Enter the criteria as ticket on hold time. We are using a custom criteria for this. We are assigning it to unassigned and then save the rule.
You can also use a combination of conditions to create a rule. Each rule can be associated with a maximum of 5 targets, and you can associate up to 25 different criteria in each rule. So let us go ahead and create a rule based on combination of criteria. Click New Direct Assignment. Enter a role name and description. Click Add Target. Enter a department name. Select a criteria. You can use any of these functions and create a combination of rules criteria. Click Save once you're done, and the rule that you just created appears here. Well, that's all we have for you in this video, where you learned about the different criteria to create direct assignment rules. Thank you for watching. For more information, contact support@zohodesk.com.